And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vassell.
Okay, today we're talking about Souvlaki Wars, a game about restaurant battles, having the best restaurant in Greece. It's a imported game that I have here, and it's very interesting. Each player is opening their restaurant and trying to sell, basically, Greek fast food to different people who are showing up at the restaurant and try to please as many of them as possible and make money at the same time. Let's take a closer look and see if the game's fun. At the beginning of the game, each player chooses one of these four different restaurants. And each restaurant that they choose will give them a different starting position on these two tracks. You can see here, down here is your reputation. At the top is how much money you have. Now, the game is in English and in Greek, and I guess you can get the rules in other languages. Most of the cards, for example, like the special cards here, they'll show a picture, it has the Greek here, and then on the bottom, it has it in English. The only exception to that is these cards here. They're only in Greek. I wish they had added four more cards with English, but it's not the end of the world. Basically, on your store card, you see your starting money, your starting reputation, which you don't even need that because they're marked on the board. And then it tells you how much your operating costs are per turn. So this guy has to pay zero per turn, but the guy who owns the red restaurant has to pay one. The guy who owns the blue restaurant has to pay two every turn. And then you can buy more cards for more money, or you can buy more reputation for money once per turn. And so it seems like they're balanced. Blue starts out in a great position, but he has a more expensive restaurant to run during the game. And red and green start out in a low position, but they have cheaper operating expenses. And it seems to be well balanced. Players are going to start with a handful of food cards. Now, these food cards will show a variety of food in different types. You get your French fries, you get your drinks, you got your gyros, you got your shish kebabs, and they might have one or two of each type. And there's a few cards in the deck that are basically a wild of each type. If you don't like your initial five, you can draw five more, but that's it. And so then each round of the game is played the same way. At the beginning of each round, we're going to take customers equal to the number of players in the game plus one. So let's say there's three players or four players. We'll put out nine customers. So each of these customers, which have hilarious artwork, by the way, so we're in a four-player game, I'm going to put out nine customers. Now, this card I just drew is a big telephone order, so that's basically like putting two customers together. So you would get both of these people, and then there you go. Now, each of these customers, let's take a look at a customer. Each customer has a certain amount of money they'll give you if you serve them, and a certain amount of reputation, and this is the food that they want. And that's basically it. It's very simple. And so each player is going to take two customers, starting with the player with the most reputation around. So let's say I take these two customers and put these guys in front of me. And then after everyone has chosen two customers, you will then draw a random customer from the deck and put him in front of you with a little phone call on him. This is a call that's been phoned in. You don't get to choose that customer. It's a random one. The reason you put the phone on it is because there's some special cards that affect the phone cards and some special cards that affect regular walk-in customers. After that, each player then has the opportunity to play a special card if they want to. These special cards can be very chaotic, and in fact, in the basic game, you don't play with them at all. But they can play these, and they will hurt other players or such. And then players are going to try to use their food cards to feed the people that they have in line. So let's say these are my food cards here. So look at the first guy. He wants a gyro and a shish kebab. And I say, oh, okay, this card gives me a gyro, a shish kebab, and a soda. He doesn't need the soda, so I'll apply the soda to the next guy in line who also needs two shish kebabs. So I play that card, and I have an extra gyro, which I'll apply to the last guy in line, and he needs a gyro and a soda, a shish kebab and a soda too, and I have an extra fries that I don't have to give to anybody, so I'll get an extra reputation point for having extra food. Doesn't matter how much extra food you have. If you have one extra food, you get a reputation point. If you have 20 extra food, you get one extra reputation point. So I served all these guys, so I get $9 and 1, 2, 3, 4 plus the extra 5 reputation, and I will move my tokens on these tracks accordingly. These customers go away. If a customer is not served, then they're agitated, they're turned sideways, and if you don't serve them by the next turn, then you will lose reputation for not serving them. Also, they move to the front of the line. Then after that's been done, before that's been done, and not in the first turn, but on second and third turns, each turn you will have to pay your operating costs, and everyone will get one free food card, and you can buy more, depending on what your store and the prices are, and you can buy reputation. You'll also be drawing one of these action cards per turn if you're playing with the action cards. And that's the game. Basically, the game continues until one player gets at least 25 in both money and reputation. That player then is considered the winner. Well, it is fun. I told you. Well, there you go. It is a very entertaining game. I'm going to see two trains of thought here. Some people are going to love those action cards because they add some chaos, and they also add a bit of a take that, you know, haha, look what I just did to you. You messed me over. Other people will not like them. Because other than that, the game's pretty simple. You're just trying to get the food cards to feed the customers. They come in a line. It's nothing really groundbreaking and new. I do like the fact that the four restaurants are asymmetrical in the sense that they're all very different, and they have different... You know, one guy can pay $2 to get three cards each turn. Another guy pays $3 to get three cards. Another guy pays $2 to get two cards. And so they're all very different. And you have to run your restaurant kind of based on what you have and how you pick the customers. Do you just always pick customers you can feed? Or do you take big customers hoping that, you know, they might get a little agitated this round, but you can feed them on the next round and get the extra money and reputation? But for the most part, this is what I would consider to be a light family game. I can see a lot of families enjoying it. The artwork, I think, is very funny. All the customers, there's a lot of funny different customers in there. Although I suspect several of them are friends and people that the designer knows. I'm just guessing there. But, you know, it's entertaining. And this is one I think that families will like and have a good time as they try to have the best fast food restaurant.
Thanks for joining us today. For more written, audio, and video reviews, as well as the number one board game podcast, check out the website at www.thedicetower.com. Until then, this is Eric Summerer, and you've been watching The Dice Tower.